at each other, man. I love it. Woo, wait. Everybody know about, heard my story about the three T's?
Yeah.
Y'all heard that. I don't have to tell.
Alex
hasn't
heard it. Alex hasn't heard it. I was like, wait.
Who have not heard the three T's? Y'all want to hear about the three T's?
Yes.
Y'all, my wife worked for Southwest Airlines. Hot diggity dog. She work in that area. And don't get me wrong, every company got a little dark area, right?
Yeah.
I don't care who you are. My wife, she worked at night. I got on the daytime, y'all. Hot diggity dog. I was like, hey, I got to get my wife up out of here. Because what happened is, that wife would come to work, she'd be mad at the husband. The husband come to work, he mad at the wife. They go home, the kids is not communicating with them, and the dog don't like them. They bring all that up into my wife's office, right? My wife, she's so meek and so kind. She just take all that, and all them demons gets on her shoulder, man. And I be at home at night, my wife come in on that telephone. She turn on the TV, and she gets on that tablet. Woo-wee! I said, baby, you can't do me like this. That's because I got precious cargo I got to haul. Man, I'm telling y'all, I got a neck worker. Man, you means no. Anytime your wife get to working those necks, it's time to roll up and go to sleep the best way you know how. If mama ain't happy, ain't nobody happy, right?
That's right.
Man, one night, I thank y'all for being on y'all's grounds. One night, my wife came home. She was on that telephone. Turn on that TV. And she got on that tablet. I looked at my baby. My baby looked at me. Thank y'all again, Southwest. I learned something. I gave her a smile. And I kept smiling. My wife looked at me. And she rolled over in my arms. She gave me a smile and rolled over in my arms. And I began to get that brown sugar, baby. I got a home. I think a smile will do it every time. I think it, dog. That's my boo woo woo woo. That's my baby boy. Hot diggity dog. Everybody know one time my wife got mad at me, right? And my wife got mad at me and she started leaving me. She started packing her bags. I started packing my bags. She said, where you going? I said, I'm going with you. I ain't letting her go. She's all I got. Although she nags me, she complains a lot. I ain't letting her go. Woo-wee! Y'all see I'm getting chills just thinking about my baby. I tell everybody, if you married to a Southwest employee, even though if you even dating one, and y'all got problems, I tell you, that's your problem. Because Southwest will write y'all a check just to smile. They'll write y'all a check just to follow the golden rule. So, hey, I tell them, man, you crazy. I ain't letting my wife go. Everybody know what BFF mean, right?
Yes.
What?
Bags
fly free. Ooh, man, check this out. Since my wife worked for Southwest, I'm going to talk about my wife. I always went to the airport, y'all. Since my wife worked for Southwest, bags fly free. And I do, too. My wife got good insurance, and I do, too. Woo-wee. How about that, Southwest? Man, I'm telling you nothing. Okay, y'all. We coming up to Herb Keller Way, right? We gonna take our moments. I got to respect this man. This man, I love him. What this man stands for, and you guys, man. Woo, I'm on the right. I get up every morning to come to work, to be in you guys' environment, to see these smiles. When I see these smiles, I know I'm on the right road. Because they tell me, ain't no smiles in hell, and I ain't trying to go. I ain't gonna get a laugh. Hey, ain't no smiles in hell. Man, y'all gonna mess around and make me a star filming me like that. I told one guy that, he said, Louis, you more than a star. I said, what? He said, you're a galaxy. Hot diggity dog. I take my hat off because my head got big. Woo-wee. Did I get that moment title for Herb Keller? I'm going to continue, y'all. We're going to keep his spirit alive, right? Uh-huh. Everybody heard about Teresa Larvey, right? Uh-huh. Okay, let me tell y'all a little bit about Teresa Larvey. Teresa was here for the years Teresa loves Southwest and Southwest love her. She was the queen like Colleen, y'all. Everybody heard about her, right?
Yeah.
So y'all know how she was. So, okay, I don't have to, y'all done heard that story?
Yeah.
Anyway, Teresa Lardy.
You met Gary Kelly, though.
You want to hear that, too?
Yeah.
Okay, let me finish Teresa first, okay?
Right.
Teresa, a hospitality queen. 2014, Teresa passed out of here. Since Teresa not from the same world, I met her. She was going out and I was coming in. Teresa lit my torch, and my assignment is to light your torch, and to light your torch, and to light your torch. Only thing I ask of you guys is, I said, what other better way in lighting torches but through Southwest? I said, we keep on lighting these torches, we gonna lighten up this world. Hot diggity dog. A lot of people see this world as a dying world. We see it as a living world. Your life is just how you look at it, right? If you look at it as dying and dead, it's dying and dead. I refuse to look into the darkness. I love looking at the light. And y'all, everybody know who the light is, right?
Jesus.
Boy, come on now. I'm going to kick you on my butt. Hot diggity dog. Ooh. So, Herb Keller, I got to tell y'all, I'm a little old bus driver, right? Yes, say yes. Anyway, yes. Let me tell you, when I first came here, I was asking, I had read that book called The Nuts. The Nuts is the history of Southwest. Tell us how we got here. So, Gary Kelly is about numbers, man. If you know how to read and you know numbers, man, you can be very successful. So I told them, they said, if you want to be successful, get around somebody that's being successful. Man, I kept on telling these bus drivers, I want to meet me some Gary Kelly. I want to meet me some Gary Kelly. They got so upset with me. So what Gary Kelly won't do with you, you little bus driver? Well, that's all right. I was determined. I said, if I can meet my God, sure I can meet Gary Kelly.
All right.
I dig it, dog. Let me tell you. So one day, Gary wrote a letter to my company. He had heard me. Y'all know he way up there. I'm way down here. My mouth's so big, he said, who is that guy out there hollering and going on? I want to meet that guy. And I got escorted up to his office by his head security guard. And when I went in there, Gary, big old office, I was like a little old country boy. I don't mind telling you. I ain't ashamed of my game. I got me to Gary Kelly's office. Let me tell you, man. Gary invited me there. And man, Gary was sitting on the couch. I was sitting on the couch. And everybody know you got 5 seconds to introduce yourself on the elevator, right? Gary was looking at me. And I was looking at him. And I thought about that. I draw back and I hit old Gary. That was with a culture knockout. Old Gary fell out. I just started telling him what I knew about Southwest. He fell out and woke up, grabbed my hand. He said, Lewis, you continue to do what you're doing for our culture. I took off running. I thought he had hired me. I've been running ever since, my mouth. I've been running. I want y'all to look over to the side. Y'all see a big red sign? I got fired from my last job. Everybody know why, right? Running my mouth. Running my mouth. Man. But I'm gonna tell you, it's a book in the Bible called Ezekiel. Somebody read that book, right?
Yeah.
God had to dry the creek up in order for him to move on, okay?
Uh-huh.
Sometimes God got to dry that creek up in order for us to move on. That happened to me. But he loved me so much, y'all. He picked me up. And look where he stuck me. In love field, y'all. I'm operating on a field of love. Hot diggity dog. Man, they offered me a whole bunch of money to come back that way. I ain't going. Man, I tell you what, money can't buy happiness. Not like this.